In this exercise, we consider 10 robots corresponding to cars turning on a circular road as illustrated by the figure. So we know the length of the road, so we also know its radius since it is circular, and each car or each robot is described by state equation corresponding to a double integrator. So A corresponds to the position of the car on the circle, and V corresponds to the speed. So each robot is able to measure a circular distance, so a positive circular distance represented by the arcs here, corresponding to the distance between the previous car and the car we consider. The objective of this exercise is to propose a controller, so a proportional and derivative controller, so that no slowdown phenomenon could appear. This video illustrates a problem where we have several cars with drivers, and each driver is asked to go to a given speed, for instance 30 km an hour, without creating any slowdown phenomenon. So we can see here that some part of the circle there is some traffic jam problem. We will assume in our problem that all cars correspond to robots and they are not able to communicate, and each car is only able to see the previous car. So there is no global vision of all the traffic on the circle. So each robot is able to measure the distance from its center to the following one, and this distance is for instance collected using a radar, and it will be called DI, and thanks to the Doppler effect the radar is also assumed to collect the derivative D dot. So we can see here that D1 plus plus DM, because we have M robot correspond, so this distance corresponds here to D3. D4 and this one to DM, so the sum corresponds to L, which is taken in the exercise as 100 meters. We can see also that the sum of the derivative D dot 1 plus D dot M is equal to 0. So we can see some relation like this. AI corresponds to the position of the robot, so it will increase, and it should be noticed that if I add L, then it will correspond to the same position as this one. So if I here I add KL, where K is an integer, it will correspond to the same position thanks to the circular circular shape of the road. Each car has also a speed, which is denoted by VI, for instance. Here it is VI minus 1, and so on. So some cars go slowly, some other have another speed, and we have to tune the speed thanks to the acceleration so that all distance are equal and all car go to a speed denoted by V0, which correspond to the desired speed. We also want that the distance between each robot corresponds to the same distance, so let's say D0 corresponds to the desired distance, and in our case it is clear that D0 equal to the length of the road divided by M, the number of robot. So here it will be 100, divided by 10 if we have 10 robots like here, and corresponds to 10 meters. Now the first question. We have to write an expression of the observation function, so from the position of two cars and the speed of two cars following each other, we have to return an expression of the output, the observation function, which generates the distance and the derivative of the distance. So this observation function depends, of course, of the state of the system, and more specifically depends of the state of two cars. So when I mean the system is the global system with the 10 cars. So we have here a special notation, I minus, which tells that it is I minus 1 in most of the case, I mean when I is positive, except for 1. For 1, indeed, when the first car, so here it corresponds to A1, the previous car does not correspond to A0, but will correspond to AM. Assume, for instance, here I have AA, and here it will correspond to A minus, so the previous one, A minus. So, of course, I will compute A minus minus AA. If I compute this, it will correspond to this distance. Okay, so we understand first that we have to compute this difference, but if this previous one is not this one because it does not exist, and so on, it can be large. Okay, so to avoid the modulo 2 P2, let's say L problem, the modulo problem, we'll consider the general case where this difference can do several turns. Okay. It can be also negative. Indeed, if I have to do more than half turn, then probably this quantity can be negative. So to avoid this, what we want to build is a positive distance. So if I compute this, I want to compute, here A minus minus AA, which corresponds to a number. And here it will correspond to the length of the road, so here L. And I want to build something like this, a function like this, which will return always a positive value, which is between 0 and L, and which will correspond to the distance from one car to the previous one. We can see that it looks like the sawtooth function, but classically as defined in this lesson, the classical sawtooth function is made for angles. So it corresponds to something like this, where here I have pi, minus pi. It is periodic also, but the period is now 2 pi. And to go from this expression to the previous one, we have to do some change, some translation, and so if we consider this one, let's say sigma the sawtooth function, sigma here of the quantity let's say x, then this one, which is sigma let's say 2, here classical one sigma 1, then we'll have sigma 2 of let's say a minus a. So I give the position of the previous car and of our car a, and it will be given by r multiplied by sigma 1, so the classical sawtooth function time of AA minus AA divided by R minus pi plus pi. As a consequence, the expression of the observation function, which will return di and d dot I, which will be given by so the previous for the first for di, I will have r sigma 1 of a minus pi plus pi, and for the derivative it will correspond to the speed of the car in front of me minus the speed of my car. All these quantities are a part of the global state x of my whole system, so of my system with 10 cars. For the simulation, I will start with a simple program where with one function which draw a car at position x with a color call. I compute the length, which corresponds to 100 meters, the length of the road, the radius of the road, and I will draw two discs, one light blue and one white for the road, and I will draw one car corresponding to XA here. Okay, so I will start with this simple program. I run it. We can see here the car with the road. So we can understand that since I ask for 25 meters and the length of the road is 100 meters, we understand why the car was on the top of the picture. Okay, so now I have more than one car. I have 10 cars, so I will need to memorize them in a matrix like this with two columns for the position and the speed, and two lines and m colon. So each column corresponds to one robot. Now I will try to initialize like this I put each car at a distance of 8 meters, and I put a minus because the first one is has a position which is higher, that's why I have the minus sign. Now I will have I will try to draw these cars. So here I will do a loop and say here for A in range of M, because I have M cars, I will compute so XA, which corresponds to the current car, so I will build a function which will isolate from X the car number I, and then I will draw them black. So I don't need to initialize it anymore, so I remove this one, this line, and I will have to program this function xi. So probably here, def xi, I have to enter my matrix x and I also, and this one will return x. So I will take the two columns, the number I modulo M, I will flatten and reshape. Dot reshape with two lines and one colon. Two dot. Here I have to put m equal to 10. And we can see here all the 10 cars represented here. So of course, if I put here something smaller, let's say 5, we can understand that the distance will be smaller. Okay. Okay, I will put 8. Now, I will have to return for the simulation the observation function, so I can put it here. I build first my circular distance, which corresponds to I give two position xA and two state for two cars xA and xB, and as explained before, I compute the difference between the two positions. I use a sawtooth function, which is given here in RobLib, so a very simple periodic function. And this circular function will be used to return the collected value by the radar. First, I have for the simulation to make move my car thanks to a state equation. So the state equation, I recall that they are given here. So I will have to make my car moving using this state equation. So it corresponds to my function f. I enter the state of my car, the input of my car. I will first flatten equal xA dot flatten. Then I will return array of with here is the speed, so xA of 1. And here it will correspond to the acceleration, which is given by u. So here I will put my observation function, which uses a circular distance, which always returns something between 0 and L. So it is always positive. And I also return the derivative of the distance, which is computed by the difference xb minus xa, as explained previously. Now I will have to do my Euler loop to enclose this one, and for this I will have to define the time dt, for instance something small, let's say 0.05. Here I will start my loop, so for t starting at 0 up to 10 with dt which is 0.05. I do pause so that I give time for the drawing, and all this I will have to put inside the loop. This one at the end. So so here I take the car, I call it XA, and I will call also name the previous car, I will call it XB. The measurement corresponds to YE, which is given by J, so the one I have programmed before, JI. Okay, JI of XA, XB. Oh, this is the measurement made by the car XA. The input UA, I can put something like 1, for instance, or 0.1. After, I will have to do the controller, which will compute the acceleration UA. I will do my Euler loop. XA, the new XA, corresponds to the old one plus F of XA and UA. I draw it, and then the new value will be stored inside the state of all cars denoted by capital X. So I take the if colon, I modulo M, and I will put XA dot flatten. So I made an error here, and also here it's plus, and of course I have to multiply by dt. Let me run the program. We can see that they are moving, but very very slowly. That's what I will put a larger acceleration, for instance this, and also okay, we can see the acceleration. So to see, to avoid the collision, I will also add here that if the circular distance, which is always positive between XA and the previous XB, is small, let's say smaller than 5, then I consider that I have a collision. So I put the speed, so the speed corresponds to the component 1, to 0 because of the collision, and I will draw it red. So okay, we'll put the black before so that I will see the red. In case of collision, I will see it. So to check the collision system is working, I will put something like A plus I, so I will provoke some collisions, since the acceleration is not the same for all the cars. And okay, I start it. We can see that the acceleration is different. The red corresponds to the collision, so that's why the first are black. I still have some collision due to different acceleration, and all this one will collide later. Okay. Now what I will do is I will have to put a controller, so that's why I will write here control of which depends on the state of the current car and what it measure, YA. This corresponds to the next question. So propose a proportional and derivative control so that the robot will go to a uniform distribution with a speed corresponding to V0. And I will have to check this through a simulation. For the controller, I have my robot RI, which is given here, and which is called as the state XA, and the previous car is here, correspond to RA minus 1. and I have to write the controller, which will be taken as proportional and derivative. So we have the desired distance which corresponds to D0, and we can see that the measured distance D here is larger. So of course we can understand that we have to accelerate, so U should be positive. So proportional part, which tell me that UE corresponds to something proportional to DE, this distance, minus D0, the desired distance. So here I can put a coefficient K, but for simplicity I will put equal to 1. We can understand, as in the case, if this is positive, U should be positive, so 1 should be okay. It is a proportional part, but it will not be sufficient, so why? Assume that I am in this situation, but the speed of this one is huge compared to the speed of this one. So in this case, there is no need to accelerate. Otherwise, I will have a collision, or I will contribute to create the jam. So in this case, there is a in this situation, I will have the distance d dot, which will be negative, since my distance gets smaller. So in this case, I should decelerate. So I will write like this. Plus d dot e, and this corresponds to the derivative part, which is important, as we'll see later by simulation. And also, I want not only to respect the distance, but also to have a speed equal to V0. I want all my cars, all my robots, go to the speed V0. That's why in the proportional part, I will also add V0, the one I want, minus VI. It means, so I put here also a coefficient which is positive, so 1. I could put something different, but it should be positive. Because if I go, here it's I, if I go slower than V0, then of course I should accelerate. So this corresponds to a proportional, thanks to this one, and derivative control. I will implement it using Python. So the controller, I will put it here. So for the control, I need the state XA, and I don't know the state of the other car. And I measure Y, which corresponds to D dot. I flatten it. Here I have the proportional part. Here the derivative part. And here the difference of speed. I should also add a value for D0 and also for V0, which is asked to be 10 meter per second. I run the simulation. We can see here that all cars after a transient phase will reach uniform distribution of all robots, which corresponds to what we wanted. Now we'll see the effect of the derivative term. If we put 0 here, I have no more derivative term. Then in this case, what will happen? Okay, so we can see that there is almost some collision. Yes, there is some collision. And the uniform distribution is not obtained. And we can see some traffic jam problems. Question 3. Now we assume the stability of the whole system and we have to study the steady behavior. When it is reached, we want to prove that all cars have the same speed V0 and are uniformly distributed. It is exactly what we have checked by simulation, but now we have to do it theoretically. Okay, so I will to study the stability. I will consider a state vector which corresponds to let's say P, the new state vector which will correspond to D1, DM minus 1. I will not consider DM because so D1 plus D2 plus so on corresponds. So let me recall that D1 plus DM is equal to L. So I don't need to consider as state variable the last one. That's why I stopped before. Now all the speed can be independent. That's why here I will add V1 and Vm. And I consider this state vector because I know that P dot will be equal to 0 as soon as the steady behavior will be reached. So for writing the state equation, I will write d dot 1, which corresponds to this one, the derivative of this one, corresponds to the speed Vm minus V1. Now we'll have d dot 2 equal to V1 minus V2, and so on. And d dot m minus 1 corresponds to v m minus 2 minus v m minus 1. Also, I will have v dot 1, which is equal to u1, and v dot 2 corresponding to U2, and V dot M corresponding to UM. So now to have a state equation, I need to replace U1, U2 by the control. So U1 will correspond to T1 minus D0 plus d dot 1 plus v0 minus v1, which is the control I have put, and this one, let me recall that it can be expressed with respect to the state variable vm minus v1. For the second one, I will write t2 minus d0 plus d dot 2, which corresponds to v1 minus v2, similar to the previous one, plus v0 minus v2. And the last one is different. It will be here dm, but dm is not as a state variable because it does not appear here. So I will replace it by L, as explained here, as L minus T1 minus and so on DM minus 1 plus D dot M. So D dot M is V M minus 1 minus VM, which are state variable, plus V0, I know V0, it is not a state variable, but I know it is 10 meters per second, minus Vm. So this is equivalent to this equation, and which can also be put under matrix form as given here. So this matrix, which is given here, this matrix is stable. So how can I prove it? I compute the eigenvalue. So it is in the case where m equal to 4. So it was, but it's it could be done also for m equal to 10, as we have, but the matrix would be too large and difficult to write. We can see L, which was here and here. And if I study the step, oh, so why is this matrix is stable? Because if I compute the eigenvalues, I will obtain minus 2, minus 1, plus or minus e, I, after I will obtain minus 1 four times. Okay, so all eigenvalues are negative, so it means that the system is stable and that this quantity will converge to some constant values. So probably this one will converge to V0, we hope so, and probably this one will converge to D0. And the derivative we have here will converge to zero. Okay. So I remove this, and I will try now to study to which value they converge. So once I got the steady behavior, so it means that this one will be equal to zero, this one to zero, all to zero. So in this case, it is clear from this equation that we'll have the speed V1 equal to V2 equal to Vm. Yeah. And I have to add also two more equations, because I know that L equal to D1 plus Dm. I know also that L equal to M times D0, so the desired distance. And from this equation, I will obtain, so I can recognize that I have some parts that are this part are common here and here. So from this, I will obtain that from this equation, I will obtain that D1 equal, since these values are equal to this value, D1 are equal to D minus M minus 1. Then, so let me sum up this. I have V1 equal V2 equal Vm. I have D1 equal Dm minus 1. I have d1 minus v1 plus v0 minus d0 equals 0. I have also minus m minus 1 d1. So I replace all distance by d1 since they are all equal. Minus v1 plus v0 minus d0 plus l equals 0. L equal to m minus 1 d1 plus dm, and L equal to m t0. Then we conclude that all the speed are equal to v0. So all the speed are equal to v0. We conclude also that all distances I had to add dm and which be equal to d0, which also equal to l divided by m, thanks to this one. So that's what I wanted. All cars go to the same speed, and all distances correspond to d0. So we have a uniform distribution, and all cars go to the same speed.